Hey everybody, Benjamin Williams here, and one of my favorite things to do is to rob hell. I don't believe that hell was made for people, but that hell is a place that should be emptied, and I love seeing people give their lives to Jesus. And I want to tell you one story that's just from a couple of days ago about leading an Uber driver to Jesus, because I think it would help you as you're reaching people and sharing your faith in Jesus Christ with those around you. And so I was in New York City with a friend of mine, Tori Marcel Harper, and he is over the Global Prayer Room in New York City in Times Square area, and the pastor of Breakthrough Culture in Times Square. And I was ministering in his church because he really wants to bring an emphasis of evangelism into his congregation and ministry there. And so we were leaving from a great time of ministry together, him and a friend Patrick, and we were in the back of an Uber car. And when we got in the car, the driver asked permission to make a phone call. And so, you know, we said, sure, and proceeded to make a phone call where she got in a pretty tense conversation with a previous customer who had left their wallet in the car. And they were trying to figure out whose responsibility it was to take care of that and how to handle it. And, you know, we're kind of in the back seat going, okay, you know, just because it's all on speakerphone. They don't have anything where they can have a handheld device. So they're just, you know, it's all through the speakers. And so finally, they kind of get done with that. And we're getting closer to the train station where I'm going to jump on the train and head back home. And I just thought, man, this lady's had a really rough day already. We just heard part of it. And so I just asked Jesus if he would show me something for her. And I had this real quick picture in my mind of a really nice scarf. It was a maroon color and was ornate, and it was around her neck. And when we pulled over, or when we were getting close to the train station, I said, excuse me, I have something that it's going to be really random. And she said, that's okay, I don't mind random. And I said, all right, well, sometimes Jesus shows me things for people, and I feel like he showed me something for you. Now, I have to be honest with you, at this point, all I had was that picture of a scarf around her. But when I started to tell her what I saw, then in my mind, really briefly quick, I saw her taking the scarf off and handing it to someone else. And so I started to describe this to her and said it was something really expensive and nice. And it's not about a scarf, but it like represented something else in her life. And so I just said, does that make any sense? It's like you gave something of value to somebody else. And she said, did Jesus see that? She pulled over. We got over close to the train station area. And she said, did Jesus see me do that? And I said, yeah, did he see you do what? And she said that she had a very valuable property that the week before she had just given to her brother, not sold it or done something else with it. She gave it to her brother, and she said she figured that he needed it more than she did, so she gave him this property. And she kept asking over and over through this whole conversation, did Jesus really see me do that? And I said, absolutely. In fact, he showed this to me to show you that he saw you, that he created you in his image, and he's crazy in love with you. And I told her that he loves her generosity and her heart for people. And I just started kind of loving on her a little bit in that way and encouraging her. And she said, well, she believes like all things are true and all gods are real. And I said, wow, well, this right here is Jesus showing you that he sees you and that he has a plan for your life. And I said, has anybody told you that Jesus has a plan for your life? And she said, not really. She said, but I pray every night before I go to bed and ask God to show me what he wants me to do with my life and what he wants to do in my life. And I told her, I said, this is the answer to that prayer. You've been praying for a long time for God to show you what he wants for you. And I said, this is it. And I said, it's to give your life to Jesus, for him to be in charge of your life. And I told her that he has a plan for her, and it starts with her asking him to be in charge of her life, and asked if she wanted to do that. And she said yes. And so there in the Uber car with my friends there, I got to pray with her, and she gave her life to Jesus. And thankfully, we had Tori right there, the pastor of a church, so I got to connect her with him and where he could tell her about their church, Breakthrough Culture. We also had in the trunk because I was heading to a train station. I had my book, The Basics in 21 Days. It's for new believers, so I hopped back there and gave her a copy of one of her books to help her start this relationship with God and to grow. And it was just a fantastic time. And so I just wanted to really briefly kind of give you a quick testimony of someone giving their life to Jesus. And it all started with me asking God, please show me something for her. She's had a rough day. And so you can do that too. You can ask God to show you things for people and then just start the conversation by being honest with them and saying, you know, this is going to be really kind of random, but you know, sometimes Jesus shows me things for people. And so that's a way you can get started, and that's kind of, you have to develop it. You don't have to have a full prophetic word to start. I just had one picture, didn't know what it meant when I first started, but I gave what I had. And as I gave that, then Holy Spirit started showing me more. And then you just interact with a person, asking them, does that make any sense to you? And just talk with them. You're not there to try to make them get saved. You're just there loving on the person in front of you. And so in this moment, she happened to be someone who had never given her life to Jesus, didn't have a church background, and she wanted to give her life to Jesus in that moment. And so I'd encourage you to love the person in front of you, ask God to show you things, and step out. How do you do it? Just start. Just tell them, listen, this might be random, but, and then go for it. And try it out and ask him if that makes sense to him. All right. So it's a little longer video than I want it to be. I'm sorry, but I hope it helps some people out. And we'll have some more things on here on our YouTube channel. Also, check out releasinglife.com for more training on evangelism, because you were made to be a witness for Christ. You were made to rob hell. I'll see you next time. Bless you.